Yo, what's going on, guys? Horcrux here. Welcome back to the channel. Before we begin today's video, just a huge shout out to my patrons. Without you guys, this channel wouldn't even be possible. And currently, 72% of the people who watch my videos are not currently subscribed. So if you could do your boy Horcrux a favor, please like and sub to the channel. That'll help keep me motivated. It'll help keep the channel growing. That'd be really appreciated. So without further ado, let's get into today's video. Okay, guys, am I the only one that noticed that Zoss actually did something for PvP? Because I know this is still kind of like the trial and error state right now. Everyone's trying to grind all the sets, put their builds together, a lot of Proctar builds, a lot of, yada yada. But has anyone ever taken the time to look at what these sets are? They're not just some random blow schmo sets, okay? So in one of the videos I talked about months ago, there's a few things wrong with Cyrodiil, okay? And some of the bane of my existences, other than Nightblades, you guys know that, are number one, tanky boys. Number two are the healy boys. And number three are the cannon boys. So I will explain what each one of these mean, but it didn't dawn on me until today. Like, I started looking at these sets, and these sets directly countered the three top things I have with Cyrodiil right now are the tanky annoying boys, who just are there to exist and to annoy you and to CC you and never die and be pocket healed, okay? There are the healy boys who smart heal everything and they don't have to have any IQ whatsoever how to heal. The smart system heal engine just heals the lowest person up to full, okay? And then there's the cannon boys. The cannon boys are the ones who roll with the Zergs and are strictly glass cannons, have no sustain, have no healing, and they just Zerg you down and they teabag you, okay? So let's take a look at these sets. So number one, I mentioned the tanky boys. All right, so let's look at the very first set here, Hrothgar's Chill. You get maximum health, you get armor, you get offensive penetration for your two, three, and four pieces. The five piece says, stunning or immobilizing your enemy causes them to burst with frost magic, applying the chilled status effect and dealing 26% of their total physical resistance and spell resistance as frost damage to themselves and enemies within 8 meters of them. This can occur every 7 seconds. Guys, this is an amazing set. Not just for mag wardens or magdens. Granted, they do have frost spell damage passives and such, but this deals with the tanks. Like, in the group, you have two or three tanks in a ball group, and this is a summation of everyone's resistances, okay? So when you're hitting a group of people with this, let's say the tank, for example, has like 80k worth of resistances just by himself, okay? So you got 40 physical and 40 magical, whatever the salt cap is, whatever tanks do these days, okay? That's 80k in total. Let's just take, 20% of that. That's 16k worth of damage. Okay, this is probably more like 17.5k, 26%, whatever, math hard, okay? And that's how much damage this set is going to do, not only to him, but everyone around him. And there's usually like 8 or 9 people like around them, am I right? So you're essentially turning the tanks against people in Cyrodiil. Like, just having tanks, if you're running this set, obviously this is probably a set you want to run in a small group or maybe even a bomber, solo build, which, I've been concocting, but this helps you deal with the tanky boys. So, the tankier they are, the more damage they take, and the more damage it disperses to everyone. This is a phenomenal set. I really actually enjoy this. I don't even mind getting killed by this. I mean, this is actually a phenomenal set, to break up the Zergs a little bit, which is obviously the problem and issue, with everyone having like zero incentive to disperse themselves around the map. So everyone, they just go in a ball group and then, this is the best way to get AP. I mean, it just is. I mean, Cyrodiil kind of frowns on solo players, but at least this set gives us a chance. So that's gonna lead us into number two set, which is Plague Break. Now, let's take a look at this set just for a second, fellas. So the two piece is offensive penetration. Three and four are both spell and weapon damage. Now, five piece, dealing direct damage to an enemy turns them into a plague carrier for 10 seconds, dealing X amount of disease damage over the duration. If the plague is removed early, it explodes, infecting enemies with 8 meters of the carrier, dealing X amount of disease damage. The explosion deals an additional 10% damage per enemy hit. This effect can occur once every 10 seconds and scales up the higher of your stats. Okay, guys, again, while this plague carrier is on you, you're inflicted with defile, which is also reducing your healing. So every single time you hit anyone in a group or a Balzerg with this, it's putting defile on everyone, a heavy hitting dot. And then again, my Healy Boy reference. Healy Boys, they smart heal and they just purge people. Like, no rhyme or reason. That's just what they do. You have a Templar, you spam Purify, and your Healing Spring, or whatever the fuck that they have, okay? And now, if you do that, you can, like, kill your own team. Because if you have Plague Break on 10 or 12 people in your little ball group, and you just fucking purge everyone at the same time, they're all going to explode, dealing a shit ton of damage to not only themselves, but everyone around them. It's like, you know, a proxy to it. I mean, that's... So you kind of have to be careful what you purify now. Which is amazing. So not only does it take care of that spec to make healing a little bit tougher. I mean, yeah, it's still going to be, you know, easy. I'm sure I'll get in the comments like, yeah, Horcruxes are better. They're just going to outheal the burst. Well, at least they're being punished for just mindlessly, you know, purifying everything, right? And then in addition to that, they have the minor, I'm not sure how much of the defile heal reduction is, but still, that's something to have as well to reduce the healing. And it's so easy to apply on everyone. And it's a very long ongoing dot, and it never stops as long as you have this up. Like, you don't have to attack one person essentially in a group, and it's going to spread to everyone. Procs and line attacks is absolutely an amazing set to deal with the Healy Boys. So, our last but not least, going into the third set here, is to deal with our Cannon Boys. And again, these are like the Glass Cannon Boys who roll with the Zergs, who just want to burst you with their entire spin to win burst combo, have no resources, and just teabag you the entire time in a Zerg. Is Dark Convergence. So, 2-piece max match, 3-piece offensive penetration, 4-piece weapon dispel damage, 5-piece. Casting abilities leave effects on the ground, create an area that applies the 30% snare. I think this is a 60% snare right now on the servers. Pulls enemies every 2 seconds after a 1 second delay, and then stun them for 1 second after. After 4 seconds, the area deals a shit ton of magic damage to all enemies in the area, and then a little bit, about half magic damage to enemies beyond the 3 meter center. And then this effect also amplifies 10% for every person affected by the spell, and this can proc every 20 seconds and it scales off your highest stat. So this set alone, of course, all of these kind of play into each other, right? Like, all these directly counter Zerging and groups of people, you know, and Balzerg, however you want to say it. But Dark Convergence in particular is the big dick bursty boy of the sets. Okay, Hrothgar, yeah, I mean, it's kind of a little situational. It's still pretty consistent. Plague Break, very consistent. But Dark Convergence, there's really not much of a counter to it, guys. Like, the past 3 days I've been playing, pretty much the only thing you can do is just, like, double roll dodge. I mean, that's pretty obvious that the balancing on this set is that it pulls you in. So now it puts you on CC immunity, so you can easily get out of it. I mean, that's a good balancing part on Azosses. But for these Zerglings that don't understand that you need to break and roll dodge, you know, they're just gonna get one shot by this. This is an absolutely good set. It's just so the people who've put thousands of hours like myself into this game will actually have a fighting chance when it comes to all these Cannon Boys and these Zergs. You know, at the very least, you know, instead of me getting Zerg down completely, getting run over, at least I can take 4 or 5 of these mofos with me, right? So if not all of them, depending on your build. I've seen some pretty nasty builds, I'm not gonna lie, with Dark Convergence. So yeah, like, Zoss has thought about this. I know you guys may disagree, but when I look at these sets, I'm like, okay, each one of these sets is addressing a different problem in Serial. I mean, of course, you still have the whole grouping in general. Like, there's no incentives on the map, really, to break these ball groups up. But, I mean, this is a really good step in the right direction, guys. And I'm thoroughly enjoying Serial right now. I mean, despite it being, you know, laggy as ever, you know, as always, you know, as predicted, but it's actually a good time. I love theory crafting. I love how they've changed up the passives, and now you can actually do hybrid builds are coming online. I'm really liking the way this patch is now, and I'm having a lot of fun. I hope you guys are doing the same. So let me know what you guys think about these sets down in the towel section. Are these just some random sets? Maybe Horcrux is just completely off his rocker and just overanalyzing these sets, but I do think they was put in for a particular reason. And if you guys have gotten stabs of these sets, I'm sure you're, I hope you're selling them, because they're going for like 1 million gold each. And here in a few weeks, they're going to go for jack shit. So if you have them now, I would just go ahead and start selling the pieces, especially if you got a good trade. But anyway, this has been Horcrux. Let me know what you guys think. Again, shout out to my Patreons, and I will catch you all in the next one. Peace.